Start rhinoceros and display the new panel in the Rhino startup dialog. Open an empty Rhino template. Position Rhino on the left side of the screen. Start Grasshopper by typing Grasshopper into the Rhino command line and position Grasshopper to the right side of the screen. Open the bimtower.gh file in Grasshopper. The view settings of the Grasshopper file are set to only draw preview geometry for selected objects, so you can see only the selected elements in the Rhino preview. If you wish to change that setting later, click on the green icon in the upper right corner among the other view setting options. A spiraling BIM tower is our last example in this training, a series of spiraling elements from both the facade and the structure of the tower. Go to the Components view in Grasshopper and drag a selection rectangle around the first 5 components as seen on the screen in order to see the elements of the tower. Let's have a look at the individual construction elements in Grasshopper that are later converted to ARCHICAD elements. The ARCHICAD type of elements are shown in capital letters in parentheses at the title of the dialogues. Before the parentheses, the Grasshopper component name is shown. Click on the boundary surfaces, slabs, components, and Grasshopper. A series of surfaces follow the spiraling shape. Each surface contains a hole for the concrete core of the tower. These will be the slab elements in ARCHICAD. Click on the related surface, ruled shell core component. The core of the building is a ruled surface in Rhino that is fed to a ruled shell ARCHICAD Grasshopper component. Click on the pipe, columns component, and proceed to clicking on the pipe, beams component as well. Columns and beams are defined for both the horizontal structural frame and the vertical structure. Click on the pipe, mullions components. The facade is made up of Grasshopper pipes that become ARCHICAD mullions, and also a morph element for the glass surface. To see the surface, click on the mesh morph glass components. A model of similar size takes a bit of time to synchronize with ARCHICAD because ARCHICAD is creating parametric BIM elements, not just previews, as Rhino does. The construction elements should be synchronized one by one by switching on the Boolean toggles. Switch each toggle from false to true. Start ARCHICAD and position it on the right side of the screen. Open the bimtowertemp.pln file and start the Grasshopper ARCHICAD Live connection as shown earlier. Navigate to the ARCHICAD Sync view in Grasshopper and switch the Boolean toggles on by clicking on the right side of the toggles one by one to synchronize the tower with ARCHICAD. Once we synchronize the model with ARCHICAD, we are able to generate plans, sections, and elevations easily. It also becomes intuitive and fast to query the model for schedules that give us information on the BIM elements of the model. Open the bimtower.pln in ARCHICAD from the Rhino Grasshopper and ARCHICAD example files folder. This file has different schedules preset in it. Click on the floor area schedule from the Navigator project map. The net and gross surface areas of the slabs can be listed as well as gross volumes of the slab, with or without holes. If we unlocked and deleted the current BIM tower in this file, then reconnected the file to Grasshopper and decided to change the design at this point in Grasshopper, then the schedules would be updated with the changed information instantaneously. Click on the contour beam schedule from the Navigator project map. The beams and columns can also be listed. For columns, it makes sense to list them based on their slant angle as shown in the schedule view. It's an option to schedule the columns based on slant angles. In ARCHICAD, we can also create visual overrides to represent information in a graphical way. Click on the Structural Hierarchy view from the Navigator view map. Structural hierarchy can be visualized by coloring the main structural core red, the slab supporting beam system blue, and the mullions in the transoms of the facade green. Click on the Function Categories view from the view map. Functional zones can also be visualized based on ARCHICAD properties of the spaces. Click on the Floor Plan Area view from the view map. This screen presents floor plan area measurements in a graphical format.